What's good? It's Marcel J. Welcome back to my channel if you're old or new. Today we are here with a reaction to most likely my favorite song at the moment. Jhene Aiko dropped it last week, May 7th, and it's called Triggered. It's a freestyle. It's beautiful as fuck. I'll get into every element of it, but it's just so fucking, for me, honestly, it was so needed at the moment, but also it's just so real. It's something that everyone can feel. Like, literally everyone can feel it. And I love Jhene Aiko. I've loved her since, like, you know, back in the B2K days when she was like with them. I think she was like a cousin or something. But when her songs used to be, or maybe it was just a feature, but I remember Pandemonium, she was on one of the bonus tracks. I loved her since then. So to see her growth is crazy. And I'm excited for this, whatever this album is, if it's like a freestyle album or just whatever it needs to be, I'm ready for it. So we're getting into Triggered and let's talk about it. Very minimum, just a little piano. I feel like I hear like nature sounds in the background.
Go figure, you were the trigger. You brought me to an obstructive view when you knew the picture was bigger. Who am I kidding? Knew from the beginning you'd ruin everything. You do it every time. You are my enemy. You are no friend of mine, motherfucker.
That line, when I first heard it, I was like, that shit hit me so, it hit me so deep. Cause it's like, when you were, sorry, I'm naturally a very sarcastic, like kind of dark humor person. I don't know if I really share it on this channel, so maybe I'll start, but I won't do it yet. When you're first getting out of a relationship or just dealing with everything ending, if it's not ending on good terms, like they're your enemy. They're someone you don't fuck with. They're someone you don't want to see on your timeline. You don't want to see their number on your phone. If you have mutual friends, you probably aren't hanging out with those friends if they're hanging out with that person. Like, just that initial feeling of rage or anger is so real and so important to like feel and release when it comes to a breakup. And Jhene releases that. There's just so many fucking stages within a breakup that are in this song. And it's all so on point. And for this all to be a freestyle makes it even more mind blowing. But that, when I first heard that line, I was like, okay, I'm sold, I'm hooked, I'm here. Whenever a song has a solid opening line, you already know. Like, you already know the artist is of quality. You already know the song's probably gonna be on repeat for a couple weeks. Like, it's just inevitable.
You motherfucking right, I'm bitter. You motherfucking right, I'm triggered. You motherfucking right, I wanna fuck you right now.
Switch up, like, I hate you, but I love you. I hate you, but I wanna fuck you right now.
That's when it would all go down. Been a minute, been a while. Ain't nobody hit it since you with it. You know you always know.
A little vibe right there, like, you're feeling it, you're in your feelings, but like, you know you wanna move. Jhene has just perfected her sound and what she wants to bring to the table. And Trip was such a fucking experience. It was so immersive with the short film. And it's such a healing fucking album. It's an album that I still go back to. Certain songs, but also in full. And I'm just, I feel what I need to feel whenever I listen to it. It's not something where I'm just like mindlessly doing a task. There's always a part of my brain that's connected to the album when I'm listening to it. And most of Jhene's music is like that. I know there was this Twitter video, not a Twitter video, but like a video released with one of the magazines where she was talking about how she used certain instruments because they're healing instruments. She wants her music to heal. She wants you to be able to process shit while you're listening to it. And this song is a perfect example of that. Like, when I listen to Triggered, I think, ooh, I get triggered. But no, I think about past relationships and situationships and dating people that I really cared about. And how I felt every emotion that she's like possessed and processed while making the song and like releasing it. And it's good, you know, feeling things are good. And coming to terms with whatever you're feeling is very real and very necessary.
Right now, don't know what I'm capable of. Might fuck around and go crazy on cuz. Might fuck around.
Oh, wait, no, that's it. This ain't the way. Hamian blood. Hamian blood.
Don't let me catch you face to face in this bitch. Trying my hardest not to disrespect you. After what you did,
the anger.
What you expected. You motherfucker.
I need to go to a Jhene show ASAP. I need to hear that song. I need to hear the audience lose their mind to it. Because songs like that, everyone feels and everyone just sings to the top of their lungs. And that's going to be such an experience when she starts performing it live, if she hasn't already. But maybe like literally a day after she posted this, or maybe a couple hours, the song, she had to take to Instagram and Twitter to explain that this song isn't directly related. Well, it could be related to her past relationship with Big Sean, because that's where everybody went. Like, oh, who hurt you? Do we need to pull up in Big Sean? Like, what's going on? But at the end of the day, like, when it came to this song, it was the song that she needed to, it was feelings that she needed to release. And as soon as she recorded the song, everything was cut. She was good. And that's the power of creativeness. That's the part of power of art. Like, being able to write your feelings down, being able to sing through them or act through them. And process what you need to process, and then just put it away. You know, maybe you'll return to it, you'll replay the song, or you'll replay those fucking emotions, the moments that led up to that song, and feel what you need to feel again. But you know, it's cool that she has, or that artists in general have, this creative, healthy way to reflect and react to what's going on with them or what's happening in their lives.
Let the time fly, yeah. Tryna let the time go by. Tryna let the time heal all. Tryna let the time kill all of our memories. All you meant to me. All that history. All that's history.
And this is the hurt. I'll come down eventually, come fall back. Like, we're not over it, but like, in this moment, we can't. This, the switch up, the like. Oh, you know, wait. You know, I love my bad habits. You know, it's hard for me to control that shit. There's just so many fucking elements of this song that I relate to, but like, those bad habits of maybe being with someone that you know isn't good for you at the end of the day, or just maybe you don't process things the right way or the healthiest way, and you know that's what it is, but like, at the same time, you gotta like process how you process. Like, I just relate so heavy. I relate to the song so heavy, and it was just so needed. I just, whenever Jhene is ready to drop that whole, and I hope it's an album of freestyles, because this song really sold me on it. She's had a lot of freestyles in the past that have been dope, like Comfort and Ending. Another one really, like recently, I can't remember the name of it, but like, she's always done freestyles, but she's really just killed me with this one.
Shoulda never did that, get back. About to feel the wrath of a menace in my bag and my feelings. I'm a bad little bitch enough. I'm triggered when I see your face. Triggered when I hear your name. Triggered, I am not okay. You need to stay out my way. Triggered when I see your face. Triggered when I hear your name.
And her voice sounds so perfect on this song. She's just like floating. Not even floating, actually. She's just like, everything's just hitting in the way that it needs to hit. Acceptance. Well, I guess it'd just be considered acceptance, this ending. An angel. And just look at the camera. Just be beautiful. Look at the camera, Jhene. It's cool. It's okay. Waste of Love. That was the name of the freestyle that dropped before this one. But yes, that was Triggered. I'm still triggered whenever I hear it. I go back to past people I've dealt with, past just emotions, and I'm very much big on reflecting, and this is the perfect song to do it with. But yeah, It's such a well-made song. And it really feels like with the song, she captured all the emotions she needed to capture within that relationship, that moment that she was discussing within the song, and left it all in the studio. So yeah, that's my reaction. I need to figure out, because I tend to do it now that my reactions are never really just reactions. They're reviews too, but I need to figure out like how I want to format that. So I'll just say the song's dope. I would give it a 10 out of 10 triggers and 10 out of 10 volcano emojis, because that's like the little emoji for her next album. I love it. Give me more music, Jhene. I'm here for it whenever it needs to come. But that was my reaction, my review. If you liked it, give me a thumbs up. If you got a song, you got an album that you want me to... you have a song you want me to review or react to, let me know in the comments. I will maybe do it soon. But I'm Russell J. Thank you for watching, for listening. See you guys in the next video. I'll see you next.